What advice would you give to people who see us, see this conversation that we're talking about, and say, I want to be able to do art as my vocation, and I want to make beautiful things, or I want to play beautiful things? What would you say to them? How would you encourage them? And that could be either in terms of being excellent at what they do, or it could be, hey, here are some safeguards, here are some things for your soul and your heart, here are some dangers of being an artist that I want you to keep in mind as you pursue that. I'll start with one. I think one of the things that can happen, even in the life of the churches, is when someone's really gifted, people are enamored by that gift, they find it amazing, and so that can turn into some good support and encouragement, but it can also turn into beginning to treat them as a different kind of person. And so that can either be in ways that over-elevates gifted people, or it can even be in a way where you elevate the gift and you stop caring for somebody's soul because you're so impressed by them. And so a lot of times artists will get a pass in the life of the church, even people who serve on Sunday morning. So it could be worship leaders, it could be people who play in a band on Sunday morning, where people aren't really, you're not really expected to be that spiritual because you're really gifted. And what that does is it does a disservice to creatives, because it means that creatives may not have as developed or as deep an understanding of who God is and how to serve him with that art. And it does a disservice to people's soul and to their ability to do that art to the glory of Jesus. And so I would want to encourage Christians and church leaders not to treat gifted people, including gifted artists in your church, as a special kind of person. So you can honor those gifts and encourage those gifts without doing things that neglect their souls and their growth as whole people. Yeah. And I think then for art, so that means for me as an artist, I have to make sure that people don't do that. So I have to make sure that I'm constantly doing things that show people even if it seems kind of impressive, once you hang out with me, you'll see I'm actually pretty boring and I'm actually pretty regular. You'll even say, maybe he's not so special. It'll just take a few conversations with me to feel that way. But it's also saying, hey, I know sometimes when I'm on the road, maybe I'm not in mind, so I want you to check in on me. I need you to check in on my soul. I just want to continually do things that keep anyone from seeing me in that way, and I want to encourage others to do that same thing.
I think church is a democracy, and I think it's a place where things are evened out. You know, I go to church on Sunday and sit beside people that I wouldn't normally select to sit beside if I had a choice.
Yeah.
And there's probably people there who wouldn't normally sit beside me, but that's part of the growing process and knowing people and sharing with people and becoming, in one sense, ordinary and not trying to sort of set yourself above. But I think church, for me, when I go, if I wasn't there, I would be lost, I would be wrecked.
Yeah.
You know, it helps me to keep right. It helps me to be normal as you can be as an artist. Mm-hmm. And I think that's church is a strengthening thing in that way.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
I think the element of servanthood is really important for an artist to see himself or herself as a servant of something greater, that we are in service both to that greater thing and to one another. Because that's sort of the antidote to idolatry, which is not just an artist problem, it's a human problem. We tend to drift into idolatry.
Yeah.
And it would be helpful in a church if artists and staff, you know, clergy, thought of themselves all as they all thought of themselves as servants. I think problems happen in churches when clergy gets to thinking that they're better than the others, you know, and stop thinking of themselves as servants as well. And if we're fellow servants engaged in a cause, pointed towards something together, a worthy goal to achieve together, we help each other along. It's a different attitude than, you know, I've got power over you, you've got power over me, you know, that becomes an endless cycle.
Yeah.
And the idolatry of starting to see ourselves as somehow different or special or superior in whatever areas that we're good, because it happens to all of us in various ways. That's a problem. That has to be offset by the concept of servanthood, I think.
That's good.
I think one thing is, I think when your art is your vocation, then the public begins to just identify you by what you do. And naturally, I think your identity becomes rooted then in what you do versus how God sees you. And so what I mean by that is, like, I put out a tweet a couple of weeks ago because I was feeling this sense of, I said, you are more than a commodity. You are more than what you are able to produce. And I think as an artist, you're always being applauded and esteemed for what you create. And I think that that makes you a slave to people's opinions, that makes you a slave to approval. And that's a dangerous space to be in. And so I think we have to be on guard with remembering, first and foremost, we're children of God. First and foremost, we're loved and seen by Him. First and foremost, we are covered in Jesus' righteousness alone. Yeah. And so even if I don't create another thing, even when I create bad things, God still looks at me and says, I love you. Amen. You know? And that's a hard line to tote, but I think that's a part of being in a community where people don't see you as an artist, but see you as a person.
Amen. Amen. Mm-hmm.